Yeah, now let us see the question what it is given here. Okay, yeah. So let A and B be the two sets containing four and the two elements respectively. That is what it is given in the question. And then number of subset of the sets A cross B, we need to find the number of subset which is having at least three elements in it. Okay, first of all, let us see what are the given things here. What they are telling, number of elements in set A will be what? Whenever respectively comes means first thing goes to A, second one goes to B, right? Number of elements in A will be what? 4. And number of elements in B will be what? It will be 2. So we already know that number of elements in A cross B, if you know the formula will be what? Number of elements in set A into number of elements in set B. So from this, what I can say? I can say will be what? It will be 4 2s are 8. Agree? So number of elements in A cross B is what? 8. So what we need to find? Number of subsets. Let us see what is the total number of subsets. What is the total number of subsets formula? Let me write it down. Total number of subsets of A cross B. Whatever may be the set. So 2 power of n is the formula. 2 power n. In place of n, what we are having? We are having an 8. So 2 power of 8 will be the total number of subsets. So but they are not simply asking us to find the number of subsets. They are asking us to find the number of subsets of the set A cross B, each having at least three elements. So at least three, what is the meaning of? First of all, we need to know what is meant by at least three. What is the meaning of at least three? You should get three and more than. Minimum will be what? Three. You can get three elements, four elements, five elements, six elements, seven elements, eight elements. Up to maximum how many? Eight elements. Instead of doing this, what you can do from the whole, total number of subsets from the whole, from the total, if you remove the zero elements, and if you remove the one element and two elements, that is also fine. Either you can do in this way or either you can do in this way, right? So now let us see. So how to do this? Now let us say number of subsets, okay, of set A set A cross B, which is having what? Zero elements. Agree? Having zero elements means what? No element. No element means what? It is nothing but zero. So what we are having? Total number of subsets. From that, what, how many there are in A cross B? How many elements are there? 8 elements. We should take what? 0 elements. What is the formula here? This will be 8C0. Agree? So if you take what? From the total, I am removing 0, 1, 2. So now let us try for number of subsets of set A cross B. Okay? Which is having to one element. First of all, let us take for one element. What is the one element from the eight elements? Eight thing, we need to consider the one. Are you getting my point here? So for your understanding sake, let me change the, this is 8C1. This is a rough work. Let us keep it aside. Are you getting my point? Similarly, what we can say? If you consider number of subsets, if you take number of subsets of set A cross B, how the subset should be? Which should have only three elements. Having three elements. What is the formula for that? You need to consider three. What is not three? Let us take two. I am sorry. This is not three. It should be two. Why? Because I am just simply removing the cases. 0, 1 and 2. So for 2, what is the formula here? This will be 8C2. Is it okay? 8C2. So finally, if I want to find the total number of subsets, which is having at least three elements, what is the formula? So if I want to find the total number of subsets having at least three elements, right? This will be at least three elements. So what is meant by at least three elements? From the total number of subsets, what I will remove? I will remove from the total, I'll remove the cases where at least three means what? You should get three and more than three. Simply, I'll remove the case we are getting one element. I'll remove the case where we are getting the two elements. I'll remove the case where we are getting zero elements. Are you getting my point here? So what is this? From the total, total number of subsets will be what? 2 power of 8 minus. What is the case? Zero elements. What is the formula? That will be 8C0. Plus removing one element. Case is what? 8C1. And removing two elements. What is that? That will be 8C2. Are you getting my point here? Any doubts up to here? Yeah. So now let us continue. For doing this for further, first of all, we need to solve these things separately. For solving this, we should have to do 8C0. What is the 8C0 formula? 8 factorial by 8 minus 0 factorial into 0 factorial. Simply, I am applying the formula NCR. What is NCR? N factorial by N minus R factorial into R factorial. So which is nothing but 8 factorial by 8 minus 0 will be what, simply 8 factorial into 0 factorial. So we know that 8 factorial can be removed, 0 factorial will be 1. So this will be what? This value will be 1. So I'll be getting 2 power of 8 minus 1 plus. What I need to find? I need to find the one more element. What is that? 8c1. What is the formula? 8 factorial by 8 minus 1 will be 7 factorial into r factorial, which is 1 factorial. I'll be left with what? What is going to be 8 factorial? I can write it as 8 into 7 into 6. So simply 8 factorial will be what? 8 into 7 into 6 into on so on. Up to where? Up to 1. By denominator will be what? 7 into 6 into on so on up to 1. Right? So from this what I can say, actually I can cancel these two elements. What is the left over? Simply 8 is left over. Right? So this is nothing but 8 here. Plus what is 8c2? 8c2 will be what? 8 factorial minus 8 minus 2 will be what? 6 factorial into 2 factorial. So what is the meaning here? 8 into 7 into, I'll write 6 factorial. This is 6 factorial into 2. 6 factorial, 6 factorial can be cancelled. 2 ones to 4s are 8. So I can take 7 4s are 28 in this case. Okay. So this will be what? 28. Are you getting my point here? Yeah. So from this, what I can say? I can say 2 power of 8. 2 power of 8 will be what? 256 minus. So 28 plus 8. This will be 36. And plus 1 will be 37. If you remove 37 from that, what will be getting? We will be getting 219. Are you getting my point here? Any doubts? Yeah. If you feel like, ma'am, this is little bit difficult or not understanding means, I will suggest you, if you want, I will be doing here. I'll give you a hint. Instead of doing, I'll give you the hint. What is the hint I am telling here? If you want to find the total number of sets having at least 3 elements, right? Total number of subsets having at least 3 elements. Having at least 3 elements. What is the meaning of at least 3 elements? Minimum it should be 3. You can take 8c3 plus 8c4 plus 8c5 plus 8c6 plus 8c7 plus 8c8. What you will be doing here, you can find its values and you can do it, okay? So for your understanding sake, first of all, let me calculate the rest of the things here. We will do it here. What is 8c3? 8c3 will be 8 factorial by 8 minus 3 factorial. 8 factorial by 8 minus 3 will be what? 5 factorial into 3 factorial. From this, what I can say? This will be 8 into 7 into 6 by 3 into 2. So this will be done, okay? So from this 7, 8 is 56 I can take. So I can got first term will be 56. Is that okay? Yeah. So let us check for 8c4. What is 8c4? 8 factorial by 8 minus 4 will be 4 factorial into, again it will be what? It will be 4 factorial. Okay. So which is nothing but 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 by 4 into 3 into 2. So 4 ones, 4 twos are 8. 2 will be get cancelled. 3 ones, 3 twos are 6. Is it okay? So I can say 7 5 is 35. 35 into 2 will be what? 70. Are you getting my point? This is 70. Second double plus 70. What is 8c5? Simply let us do that also. 8 factorial by 8 minus 5 will be what? 3 factorial into 5 factorial. What it will be? Simply if you see here both are equal, I will be getting 56 again. So this will be 56 plus. What is 8c6 here? 8c6, which is 8 factorial by 8 minus 6 will be 2 factorial into 4 factorial. Is it okay? It should be 6 factorial. Okay. Which is 8 into 7 by 2. 2 ones, 2 fours, 8. So this will be 28 plus. Again, 8c7. What is 8? This is 28. Okay. What is 8c7? 8c7. Actually, I can write it as what? 8 factorial by 8 minus 7. 1 factorial into 7 factorial. I will be getting 8 alone. Okay. And what about 8c, last term will be 8c8. What is 8c8? 8 factorial by 8 minus 8, 0 factorial into 8 factorial. This will be what? This will be 8 plus 1. Are you getting my point? Yeah. If I count it here, 56 plus 1. Yeah. Now what we got? We need to add it, right? So 56 plus 70 will be, 56 plus 56 will be what? 112. 112 plus 70 will be what? 182. 182 plus 28 will be what? This will be 2, 1, 10. Yeah. So 2, 1, 10 plus 9 will be 2, 1, 9, right? If you check into here, this one is nothing but the same, this one, what we got here. Is it okay? So either you can do this in the two ways. What is your way here? You can take at least three elements, means what, from the total number of subsets. You can remove the zero case, one element case, two element case, or you can take what, at least three means what, three elements case, four element, five, six, seven, eight. Total number of subsets will be one. Totally eight. That is how I can do it. Is it okay? Yeah. Thank you.